Hello everyone, welcome to Arpita Sharma classes. I am Arpita Sharma, your educator, and today we are going to conduct prelims masterclass for 12th December 2019. Aap sabhi ka swagat hai Arpita Sharma classes mein. Main hu Arpita Sharma aur aaj hum conduct karne wale hain bahut hi important class 12 December 2019 ki Hindu newspaper, Indian Express, PIB aur PRS ko cover karenge. Now today's class is going to be really very special because today I am going to cover the current affairs from the newspaper, PIB and PRS, RSTV also, the website RSTV also in prelims and mains format. For example, if there is a news on any bill or act, I am going to frame a prelims based question on that and mains based question on that, and then we are going to answer it, right? It will be a fun way to understand current affairs from UPSC exams perspective. So aaj ki class kaafi important hone wali hai. Kyun? Kyunki aaj ki class mein na hum bahut hi twisted way mein taiyari karenge. Matlab jitne bhi current affairs ab newspaper ya PIB ya PRS website se le rahe hain, unko hum prelims ke question format aur mains ke question format mein samjhenge. Alright, now let's begin, but before that, here's a small announcement for all of you. Unacademy Plus has several courses by India's top educators. As you can see, answer writing courses are there. Courses on geography is also there on Unacademy Plus. Journal studies course by Mrunal sir is also available. Then Dipanshu sir is taking NCRT summary class from December 13. From tomorrow this class is starting. Subscribe now if you want to cover NCRTs from class 6 to class 12. Aman Sharma sir is covering current affairs complete course, right? And many other courses on optional subjects are also available on Unacademy Plus. Unacademy Plus mein current affairs ho jaye ya fir aapki NCRT 6 se 12th ki ho gayi ya fir backlog ho gaya current affairs ka, optional subject ho gaye, sabhi covered honge. You can get subscription for either 12 months, 6 months, 3 months or 1 month according to the needs of your preparation. Aapki preparation needs ke hisab se aap courses subscribe kar sakte hain. When you click on get subscription button over here, agar aap get subscription button pe click karenge, these are the choice of subscription. If you want to pay for 12 month subscription, then click on 12 month. If you want to pay for 6 month subscription, 32,000. 3 month subscription, 20,000. And over here, if you type Sharma 20, agar idhar aap Sharma 20 type karenge and you will apply it, you will get 10% discount straight away. Idhar aap dekh sakte ho, 10% discount mil gaya, 18,000 ka course pad raha hai 3 months ka. Right? So this is much more affordable if you compare it with the offline coaching classes, much more comfortable. Everything will be at the comfort of your home. Your preparation journey will become much more easier and simpler through Unacademy Plus. Plus there are live doubt solving scene, you know, classes also on Unacademy Plus. Agar aapka koi bhi doubt aata hai na taiyari ke time par, to Unacademy Plus pe doubt, live doubt class, you know, jo bhi aapke doubts hain usko solve karne ki classes bhi hain. So Sharma 20 code use karke 10% ka discount le sakte hain, aur koi bhi course aap एक पर्टिकुलर सब्सक्रिप्शन लेंगे, चाहे वो 3 मंथ का हो, 6 मंथ का हो, आपको सारे कोर्सेज अवेलेबल होंगे उतने टाइम पीरियड के लिए. इफ यू टेक सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर 6 मंथ, 12 मंथ, 24, 3 और 1 मंथ, एवरी क्लास ऑन अनअकैडमी प्लस विल बी एक्सेसिबल टू यू फॉर दैट टाइम पीरियड. ओके, नाउ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आवर क्लास टुडे. अपनी क्लास के साथ शुरू करते हैं. नाउ ऑल ऑफ यू मस्ट हैव स्टडीड द सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट बिल. अभी तक हमने लास्ट की 4-5 क्लास में कवर किया है. इन द लास्ट 4-5 क्लासेस आल्सो वी हैव कवर्ड इट. सो नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व. देयर इज अ न्यूज ऑन पेज नंबर 1 ऑन द हिंदू न्यूज़पेपर. आफ्टर अ हीटेड डिबेट, आरएस क्लियर्स, राज्यसभा क्लियर्स सिटीजनशिप बिल. ये न्यूज है हिंदू के पहले पेज पे. सो क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस कैन बी कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स ऑन सिटीजनशिप अमेंडमेंट बिल 2019. द बिल अमेंड सिटीजनशिप एक्ट 1955. The bill grants citizenship on the basis of religion to non-Muslim communities from Afghanistan, Bangladesh and Pakistan who entered India on or before December 31, 2016. Citizenship is granted by relaxing requirement of residence in India for citizenship by naturalization from 11 to 5 years for these migrants. Select the correct statement or statements given above. Is it 1? Is it 2 and 3? Is it 1 and 3 or is it all of the above? Tell me in the comment section. Read the statements very carefully before marking the bubble. OMR sheet पे bubble को mark करने से पहले statement को बहुत clearly पढ़ना, end तक, full stop तक. Correct statement is correct answer is option C because statement number 2 is wrong. It's 2014 not 2016. That's why I was telling you to read the statement till the very end. Okay? Samajh aa gaya? Second statement wrong hai. Statement 1 or 2, 3 correct hai. Moving on to the mains based question on this topic. A mains based question kya sakta hai? What do you mean by illegal migrant? Critically analyze Citizenship Amendment Bill 2019. This can be your mains based question in GS paper 2. Now first of all introduce your topic in 2-3 lines. 2-3 lines mein apne topic ko introduce karo. Citizenship Amendment Bill ke baare mein baat ho rahi hai na? We are talking about CAB, so we have to introduce it. Union Cabinet cleared Citizenship Amendment Bill that seeks to grant citizenship to non-Muslims refugees from Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan if they faced a religious persecution there. So this is a very short introduction, very short summary of what this bill is all about. Introduction has to be kept very small. Introduction ko bahut chota rakhna hai. But it should be very creative and very effective. The examiner should know through your introduction that you know well about the topic. Introduction aapke examiner ko ye batane ke liye hota hai ki haan bhai hume is topic ke upar achhi khasi jankari hai. To introduction ko is tarike se frame karna hai ki pehla impression hi achha pade. We have to frame introduction in such a way that our first impression on the examiner is very good. And it has to be two to three lines only. So you have to be very analytical and creative, okay, and very spontaneous. मतलब आपको बिल्कुल on the point उस वक्त बहुत ही creative और analytical होना है कि 2 से 3 lines में ही मैं ऐसा introduction दूँ कि examiner पे मेरा impression अच्छा पड़े. Because your introduction will decide the overall marks of your answer, right? So introduction can change the mood of the examiner also. Introduction आपके examiner का mood भी change कर देता है, okay? So introduction is here. Now the first demand of the question is what do you mean by illegal migrant? Pehla demand hai question ka illegal migrant hota kya hai? So we have to fulfill the first demand of the question. An illegal migrant in India is a person residing in the country without official permission as prescribed by relevant Indian law. Those who are explicitly granted refugee status do not fall under this category. Now this line shows the examiner that you have extra knowledge on the topic of illegal migrant, that your hold on the definition of illegal migrant, your analytical skills on this topic is good, right? Is perfect. तो आपका ये जो extra line आप लिखते हो ना कि जो लोगों को refugee status दिया गया है वो इस category में नहीं आते, इससे examiner को ये समझ आएगा कि भाई इस बच्चे को illegal migrant topic के ऊपर अच्छी खासी जानकारी है, right? So introduction clear. First part of the question solved. Second part of the question says critically analyze CAB 2019. The question says critically analyze. There are two words in the question. Is question mein do words hai, critically and analyze. Critically means bring out the pros and cons of the topic. That is the criticism also and the cons, pros and cons both parts. And analyze. Analyze means you have to show the examiner that analytically you have understood the topic very well. तो क्रिटिकली एनालाइज का मतलब होता है क्रिटिकली मतलब क्रिटिसिजम्स भी इसके सामने रखने पड़ते हैं हमें टॉपिक के. और एनालाइज का मतलब क्या होता है कि आपको एग्जामिनर को ये दिखाना है कि एनालिटिकल स्किल आपकी इस टॉपिक के ऊपर एनालिटिकल एबिलिटी कितनी स्ट्रॉन्ग है, आपने कितने अच्छे से एनालाइज किया हुआ है. So Citizenship Amendment Bill seeks to allow illegal migrant from certain minority communities. All these topics which we have studied in the past, you know, 2-3 days you have to study, you have to write it down. Then over here, what do you mean by illegal migrant? Ye option ho gaya, critically analyze mein analyze ho gaya. Now critically, that means criticism. Why this bill is being criticized? Okay, all these points we have discussed in yesterday's class. Kal ki class mein humne criticism ke sare points bahut achhe se samjhe the. So these points you have to mention, then you can conclude your answer by in 2-3 lines. 2 se 3 lines mein apne answer ko conclude karna hai. Now next topic, 50th PSLV launch carries radar satellite. Page number 1, the Hindu newspaper. Hindu newspaper ke page 1 pe ye news hai. Now if you have studied the news, if you have read the newspaper today, answer this question. Question number, consider the following statements. RESAT-2BR-1 is an Indian radar reconnaissance satellite that is part of India's RESAT program and the 6th satellite in the series. Statement number 2, mission duration is planned to be 10 years. It's meant for applications in various fields like agriculture, forestry and disaster management support. Select the correct statements. If you have read the news, you will be in a position to answer it. Agar aapne news padhi hai. To aap isko answer kar paoge. I'm giving you 3 seconds to answer this question. Correct answer is C. Statement number 3 is correct. Statement 1 and 2 are wrong. Because this is the fourth satellite and mission duration is 5 years. Okay. So these small information and not, you know, you can say points are very crucial in answering questions in prelims. Ye chote chote topics ke andar jo knowledge aur information hoti hai, ye samajhna aur learn karna kaafi zaruri hai. Alright. C is the correct answer. Now let us understand about this particular satellite. Now, ISRO's rocket PSLV C-48 blasted off from spaceport carrying India's radar imaging Earth observation satellite, which is RESAT-2BR1. This launch has marked a very important milestone for ISRO as it is the 50th flight of PSLV and also the 75th vehicle mission from Sriharikota. Now, RESAT-2BR1 is Indian Radar Reconnaissance Satellite. It is a part of RESAT program. And it is the fourth satellite. Mission duration is 5 years, you have to remember. And its usage is in the field of agriculture, disaster management, forestry. Okay? In fields mein iska usage kiya jayega. Army deployed in Assam, Tripura is violence spread. Now, why the people of Assam are protesting? We have covered this in yesterday's news analysis also. Humne kal ke news analysis mein bhi isko cover kiya tha. Now, the people of Assam are angry. Because of the Citizenship Amendment Bill, right? So angst against this bill rooted in a fear that illegal Bengali Hindu migrants from Bangladesh, if regularized, will threaten cultural and linguistic identities. Agar illegal Bengali Hindu migrants jo Bangladesh se hain, unko regularized kar diya gaya, legal, unko citizenship de di gayi, to isse Assam ki jo cultural and linguistic identities hain, wo khatre mein pad jayengi. Wahi jo Assam Accord sign hua tha, usse pehle jo dange ho rahe the, aur usse pehle jo protest ho rahe the, wahi protest same ab ho rahe hain. Students, activists, writers, actors, musicians, people from all walks of life, they came out on the streets to voice their angst against the bill. Because they are saying that our political destiny and livelihood are becoming threatened because of this particular bill. Our linguistic identities, cultural identities will be threatened because of this bill. That is why people of Assam are protesting. Now, areas which are exempted in this bill. There are two categories that have been given exemption. Amit Shah ji ne sadan mein bataya tha ki do categories hain jiske under jo states aayenge, unhe exempt kiya ja raha hai is bill ke provision se. The states protected by inner line permit and areas covered under 6th schedule of constitution. Inner line permit, I told you what is it? It's special permit that citizens from other parts of India require to visit a state protected by the ILP regime. Ab wo states jin jo ILP regime ke under protected hain, wahan jane ke liye agar aap logo ko wahan travel purpose se jana hai, visit karne jana hai, rukne ke liye nahi, visit karne jana hai, travel, ghoomne jana hai, tourism ke purpose se jana hai, to aapko ye ILP permit lekar jana padega. Without an ILP granted by state government, an Indian from another state cannot visit a state that is under the ILP regime. Okay. Now, 6th schedule. 6th schedule relates to special provisions administration of certain northeastern states. It provides special powers for ADCs in these states. In states, mein ek autonomous district councils taiyar ki gayi hain, jinko 6th schedule special powers deta hai. The powers to enact laws in areas under their jurisdiction on variety of subjects. Right? So, the states falling in the 6th schedule and ILP are exempted from this bill. Now, state by state, let us see. Assam, the state has 3 autonomous district councils, so it falls under 6th schedule. While these are protected, CAB will be in effect in a larger area, right? Jo ADCs wali areas hai na, wahan par to ye bill kaam nahi karega, but baki ke areas mein ye bill kaam karega. The areas protected through ADCs, those areas are exempted, but rest of the other areas are not exempted. Meghalaya, this state too has 3 ADCs. Tripura, one ADC covers around 70% of the state's area and 30% holds about 2/3 of the population. So, CAB is effective in the smaller, more densely populated regions in this state. Arunachal Pradesh is covered and entire state is covered under ILP regime. So, it is protected from CAB. Nagaland, entire state is covered under ILP. Kal to Dimapur bhi a gaya, right? In the yesterday's class, we saw that Nagaland has also extended ILP to Dimapur. So, now the whole state is exempt. Pehle to ye baat thi ki Dimapur ko chhod ke pure Nagaland exempt hoga CAB ke provision se. But ab Dimapur bhi a gaya hai. Mizoram, entire state covered under ILP regime will be protected. Manipur, entire state gets new ILP protection. Okay, so you have to remember these states and the areas which are protected for your prelims. Now practice this question yourself. Citizenship Amendment Bill not only excludes Muslims but creates other complications. Analyze. अब आपको ये क्वेश्चन, अब तक तो सारी इंफॉर्मेशन समझ आ गई होगी, तो इसको खुद से प्रैक्टिस करना है. नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर 3, आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. द प्रेजेंट कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन ऑफ इंडिया वॉज फ्रेम्ड बाय एन इलेक्टेड कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट असेंबली एंड वॉज फॉर्मली अडॉप्टेड ऑन 26 January 1949. इट केम इन टू फोर्स ऑन 26 January 1950 एज डिजायर्ड बाय पंडित नेहरू. Constituent Assembly was set up under Cabinet Minister proposal to draft a constitution for independent India. And the first meeting of Constituent Assembly took place on December 9, 1946 with Dr. Sachidanand Sinha as the interim president. If you have studied spectrum chapter by chapter, na, then you will be in a position to answer this question perfectly. Agar spectrum ki kitab aapne acche se padhi hai na, ya Bipin Chandra ki kitab acche se padhi hai, to koi doubt hi nahi hai, ye question galat aap mark karo. But if you haven't studied properly the books, the NCRTs, then you are not going to attempt this question correctly. Correct answer is all of the above are correct. B is the correct option. All right. Now this news, you just have to go through it. Not very important. Ye important nahi hai. Delhi edition of Hindu newspaper mein aayi hai. Good governance ka example. It's just an example of good governance. Okay. Richard Branson to meet Uddhav to seek clarity on Mumbai-Pune Hyperloop. So, Mumbai-Pune Hyperloop project is important. What is Hyperloop? It is a next generation travel system that uses pods or capsules traveling at high speeds through low pressure tubes erected on columns or tunneled underground using magnetic levitation. Now, I'll just make you see what is Hyperloop. So, this is Hyperloop. As you can see, small tunnel in which this tube-like structure is there where people will be seated. These are the seats. Okay, so it's a capsule with passengers which travels at speed of more than 1200 km per hour inside a vacuum tube. Ek capsule jaisa hai jisme log baithe honge, 1200 km per hour ki speed pe ye, isse zyada ki speed pe ye travel karta hai, right? It can be built in India in 38 months. Globally, 800 engineers working on the Hyperloop, of which 25 are from India, you can say. And this Hyperloop uses power from renewable energy, for example, wind power, सोलर एनर्जी, राइट? तो रिन्यूएबल एनर्जी से ये पावर लेता है हाइपरलूप. वैक्यूम ट्यूब हैज एन एरिया ऑफ लो प्रेशर इनसाइड इट. ओके, सो दीज पॉइंट्स आर इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर प्रीलिम्स. ये दिस इज द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ हाइपरलूप, एज यू कैन सी वेरी क्लियरली ओवर हेयर. ऑल राइट, नाउ व्हाट वॉज ब्रांसन प्लान? ब्रांसन्स वर्जिन हाइपरलूप वन प्रपोज्ड अ हाइपरलूप बिटवीन मुंबई एंड पुणे. सो रिचर्ड ब्रांसन का जो वर्जिन हाइपरलूप वन है, उन्होंने ये प्रपोज किया कि मुंबई और पुणे के बीच में हाइपरलूप तैयार किया जा सकता है जो कि ट्रैवल टाइम को सिर्फ 25 मिनट, 3 घंटे लगते हैं पर अब 25 मिनट लगेंगे मुंबई से पुणे ट्रैवल करने के लिए. इट वुड लिंक सेंट्रल पुणे नवी मुंबई इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट एंड मुंबई एंड इट विल रिड्यूस द टाइम फ्रॉम 3 आवर्स टू 25 मिनट्स बिटवीन द टू प्लेसेस. द रूट वुड बी 100% इलेक्ट्रिक विच मीन्स रिडक्शन ऑफ ग्रीन हाउस गैस एमिशन ऑल्सो. द प्रोजेक्ट इन्वॉल्व्स कंस्ट्रक्शन अक्रॉस लेंथ ऑफ 117.5 किलोमीटर. What did Maharashtra government do to take forward the proposal? It was categorized as a public infrastructure project. So it received cabinet clearance, right? जल्दी से जल्दी track को test करने के लिए और project को implement करने के लिए public infrastructure project की category में इस project को डाला गया और cabinet clearance दिलवाई गई. Pune Metropolitan Region Development Authority was assigned the task of overseeing the implementation of this project. And the government decided to use the Swiss challenge method for the bidding of the project in order to invite investors, the funds. Okay? Clear? So, is tarike ka method use kiya jata hai public infrastructure projects ke liye, funds gather karne ke liye, bids gather karne ke liye. So, Swiss challenge, remember what is it for prelims? Okay? Swiss challenge is a method for bidding of a certain public infrastructure project, for collecting funds for certain public infrastructure projects. Okay? AP cabinet clears Disha bill to ensure rape verdicts in 21 days. Andhra Pradesh cabinet has cleared AP Andhra Pradesh Disha bill 2019, which is Andhra Pradesh Criminal Law Amendment Bill 2019, for fast tracking the verdict in trials of such cases, rape and murder cases, to 21 days. Cabinet also gave its permission for introduction of Andhra Pradesh Special Court for specified offence against women and children bill 2019. So these steps are very important. Go through these particular steps taken by Andhra Pradesh. It is also a part of, you can say, you know, jab bhi good governance, because is tarike ki situations aati hain to wo kafi states jald se jald aise gunahon ko saza dilane ke liye kuch na kuch act ya bill pass karte hain. To Andhra Pradesh ke step ko aapko acche se padhna padega. Under Section 354E, harassment of women through social media, digital mode or any other form, it has been proposed to sentence the guilty to imprisonment for up to 2 years on first conviction and 4 years on the subsequent conviction. Pehli bar convict hota hai person, to 2 saal ki imprisonment. Agar fir se uske upar koi aisa case aata hai, to 4 saal ki imprisonment. Okay? Heavy metals contaminating India's river. So this particular survey has been highlighted in the Hindu newspaper. So based on this survey, this question can be framed. Is survey ke basis pe ye question aa sakta hai. Consider following statements based on third edition of an exercise conducted by Central Water Commission from May 2014 to April 2018. Samples from only 1/3 of water quality stations were safe. Iron emerged as most common contaminant, with 156 of sampled sites registering levels of metal above safe limits. Other major contaminants were lead, nickel, chromium, cadmium and copper. Arsenic and zinc are two toxic metals whose concentration was always obtained within the limits throughout the study period in the 4 years, last 4 years. So if you have studied this particular news today, you will be in a position to answer this question. Agar aaj aapne ye news padhi hai na, to aap answer kar sakte ho. Correct answer is C. All the above statements are correct. So these types of questions can be framed from data also, surveys also. जो different surveys आप पढ़ते हो ना, उसको पढ़ के छोड़ मत दिया करो. इस तरीके के questions बन जाते हैं उन particular topics में से. So this is the survey data. You can take a screenshot of it, or you can take out the cutting from the Hindu newspaper and stick it in your current affairs notebook. Okay? The not so bright idea of selling the family silver. Government may not be striking pay dirt in privatizing public sector undertaking, especially the profitable BPCL. Now this was the editorial in the Hindu newspaper. Ye aaj ke newspaper mein editorial hai. So question in GS paper 3 can be framed, why privatization of BPCL will be a good thing for all stakeholders. So BPCL ko privatize karne ki baat ho rahi hai, to wo achhi baat kyun hogi, is tarike ka question ban sakta hai. Government, I am giving you the hint also, government is selling its BPCL stake to IOC and it can create a monopoly in the oil marketing business. And privatization would realize a higher price and may take help politics out of auto fuel pricing. First in this question, explain what is privatization. Pehle to isme explain karna, pehle part mein introduction mein privatization hota kya hai. Then explain why it will be good thing for all the stakeholders. I have given the data and the points over here. I will be uploading the PDF on the Telegram channel. Link is given below in the description box. Okay, so you can check it out. Aap is editorial ke matter ko check out kar sakte ho Telegram channel mein. Abhi ek ghante ke andar link aapka jo PDF hai wo Telegram channel mein upload kar diya jayega. A law not based on religion. Again, this is an editorial from the Hindu newspaper only. So this is important for prelims perspective. Now, refugees fleeing civil violence in Pakistan were exempt from 1950 Immigrants Expulsion Law. So what is Immigrants Expulsion Law or Act? This was an act to provide for expulsion of certain immigrants from Assam. This bill allows for illegal migrants, immigrants to be expelled not because they were Muslims, but because they were not citizens of the country. So therefore, the bill did not violate the secular character of the state. किसी ने ये कहा, एक मीडिया बीजेपी स्पोक्सपर्सन ने, कि हमने वही काम किया है जो नेहरू जी ने 1950 में किया था. बट ऐसा नहीं है. 1950 का जो ये एक्सपल्शन एक्ट था, इसने इमिग्रेंट्स, इलीगल इमिग्रेंट्स को बाहर निकालने की बात कही थी, ना कि रिलीजन के बेसिस पे किसी को बाहर निकालने की या अंदर लाने की बात हुई थी. राइट, सो देयर वाज दिस बीजेपी स्पोक्सपर्सन हु सेड दैट वी हैव डन व्हाट नेहरू जी डिड इन 1950. दैट्स रॉन्ग, बिकॉज इन 1950 दिस एक्ट वॉज एमिंग फॉर ओनली एक्सपेलिंग इलीगल इमिग्रेंट्स. Not this bill was not made on the basis of or on the lines of secularism, okay, religions. Now this is a very important topic. Amit Shah referred to the Nehru Liaquat Pact on a few occasions in Parliament to justify the citizenship bill. So what is Nehru Liaquat Pact can be asked in GS paper 1 or in prelims. So Amit Shah ne Parliament mein kafi baar Nehru Liaquat Pact ke baare mein baat ki thi. राइट, अपने सिटीजनशिप बिल को जस्टिफाई करने के लिए. तो ये पढ़ना जरूरी है. द लियाकत नेहरू पैक्ट, और इट इज आल्सो नोन एज दिल्ली पैक्ट, इट वाज अ बायलेटरल ट्रीटी बिटवीन टू साउथ एशियन स्टेट्स, इंडिया एंड पाकिस्तान, वेयर रिफ्यूजीज वर अलाउड टू रिटर्न टू डिस्पोज ऑफ देयर प्रॉपर्टी, अबडक्टेड वुमेन एंड लूटेड प्रॉपर्टी वर टू बी रिटर्न्ड इन द पॉइंट ऑफ पार्टीशन. Forced conversions were unrecognized and minority rights were confirmed. Partition के दौरान पे जो भी हरकतें गलत काम हुए थे उन सबको सही करने के लिए ये पैक्ट साइन किया गया था. The treaty was signed in New Delhi by Prime Minister of India Jawaharlal Nehru and Prime Minister of Pakistan Riaqat Ali Khan on April 8, 1950. And the treaty was the outcome of 6 days of talks in order to guarantee the rights of minorities in both the countries after partition of India. So whatever bad thing, whatever wrong things happened after partition, during the partition, all those were both the countries tried to reverse it through this pact. That pact was opposed by Shyama Prasad Mukherjee, founder of Bharatiya Jan Sangh, who relinquished his position as cabinet minister when Nehruji went ahead with the pact. So you have to remember this also from prelims perspective. So if we summarize it, under the Nehru-Liaquat pact, refugees were allowed to return unmolested to dispose of their property. Abducted women and looted property were to be returned. Forced conversions were unrecognized and minority rights were confirmed. Remember these 4 points. Lok Sabha passes bill to set up unified authority for financial services. So Lok Sabha has passed International Financial Service Center Authority Bill, IFSC Bill, Authority Bill 2019 ka pass kiya gaya hai for establishment of an authority to develop and regulate financial service market. Jitne bhi financial service market hai unko regulate karne ke liye, develop karne ke liye is bill ko pass kiya gaya hai. The unified authority would act as a single window of regulation. Currently, the banking, capital market and insurance sector in IFSC are regulated by multiple regulators. But this bill will be one-stop solution for all of these. Okay? The bill seeks to amend 14 acts including SEBI and IRDA and PFRDA Act also. Now, who is covered under this bill? The bill will be applicable to all IFSCs set up under the special economic zones. And the first IFSC in India has been set up at the Gujarat International Finance Tech City in Gandhinagar. This point is important from prelims perspective. Ye point aapka prelims perspective se important hai. New Social Security Bill tabled in Lok Sabha. So, Labour Minister has introduced Code on Social Security 2019. The bill seeks to amend and consolidate laws relating to social security of employees, subsuming the 8 central laws. Okay, so go through this particular page also. These small acts and bills are important from prelims perspective. Okay. Data Protection Bill referred to joint panel. Lok Sabha has referred Personal Data Protection Bill 2019 to a joint select committee. Now, this question can be framed on this particular news. Is news ke upar ye question banaya ja sakta hai. Consider the following statements on draft bill, the Personal Data Protection Bill 2018. The bill deals with the broad guidelines on collection, storage and processing of personal data, consent of individual, penalties and compensation, code of conduct. Draft bill also has a provision for the right to be forgotten, where person shall have the right to restrict or prevent continuing disclosure of personal data. Personal data is to be stored in India but can be processed outside with the consent of the person, focusing on the line consent of the person. The draft bill also specifies penalties for not following its provisions, including penalty of 10 crore or 8% of turnover, whichever is higher, if no action is taken on a data leak. Now tell me which option is correct. 5 seconds ka time hai aapke paas, jaldi se bataiye kaun sa option sahi hai. So the correct option is B. Statement 1, 2 and 3 are correct, but statement 4 is wrong because it is not 10 crore, it's 5 crore and not 8% but 2%. Okay. Now Bougainville votes to become world's newest country. Again, very important news for prelims perspective. Voters backing Bougainville's independence from Papua New Guinea have won a landslide referendum victory. A major step towards Troubled Isles becoming the world's newest nation. Okay, so this news is very, very important from prelims perspective. Question number 6, answer this question. Consider the following statements with respect to leopard. It's listed at par with tigers under Schedule 1 of WPA 1972. It is vulnerable on IUCN Red List. It's a nocturnal animal. फटाफट से बताओ कौन सा स्टेटमेंट सही है. टेल मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन विच स्टेटमेंट इज करेक्ट. डी इज करेक्ट. ऑल द अबव स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट. ओके, डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Not to ring fence successful IBC suitors, Union Cabinet has approved proposal to make amendments in Insolvency Bankruptcy Code 2016. तो अमेंडमेंट्स जो हैं वो आप एक बार देख लीजिए इधर. द अमेंडमेंट्स एम टू यू नो रिमूव द सर्टेन डिफिकल्टीज बीइंग फेस्ड ड्यूरिंग इंसॉल्वेंसी रेजोल्यूशन. ओके, सो दिस वाज ऑल फॉर टुडे. आई होप यू एंजॉयड द क्लास. इफ यू रियली एंजॉयड टुडेज क्लास, डू टेल मी इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. डू टेल योर स्कोर्स इन द कमेंट सेक्शन. नेगेटिव मार्किंग ऑफ 0.66 मार्क्स एंड ईच प्रीलिम्स बेस्ड क्वेश्चन इज ऑफ 2 मार्क्स. ओके, टेल मी योर स्कोर्स इन द कमेंट सेक्शन.